So today we're going to be testing out a build that I think a lot of you guys will probably enjoy. I threw it together, wanted to have a shotgun build that had a lot of survivability. So been having used a shotgun build in a long time without the Scorpio. So I was like, you know what, let's get something that doesn't have the Scorpio. And let's see what this does. I just want to see. Wanted to see how this would do. Come on, let's see what we got. Ooh, baby, yeah, yeah. They're up top? I think they're up top. Let's get this guy over here. It looks like gold enemy is 2 to 3 shots. Where are they? It's up top? I think they're up top. Nice. Oh, wrong gun. Yeah, this thing is nice. Yo, this is... Wow, this almost isn't fair. Oh, it's so dark in here. What the? The lights went out. Oh my Jesus. Too easy. Who's left? I think we just got the guys over here. Additional hostile contacts. Scumbags. Get rid of all these nades, man. Alright, there we go. Oh, I was a little worried. Where are these guys at? So dark. Yes, I didn't have to fight that dude. Can't see because the fire is really killing me. Okay, but besides that, wait, no. Okay, it's pretty easy, baby. Yeah, I definitely am liking this. I think that's it, right? Yeah, that's it right there. So if you guys want to get into the build, let's do it. So you guys probably noticed I was running this shotgun right here, and you're like, wow, that gun actually looks really good. Well, this is the named SX-12, I believe that's what it is. So this is the MOP shotgun. This thing is actually pretty sick looking, just looking at it from the beginning. Just take a look at that. That thing is actually really nice. So what we'll do is we'll break down the full build, because I know a lot of you guys want to see different builds. And a lot of these builds are just like tweaking things here and there, but most of my builds are on the build playlist. But let's get into the whole build. So the first thing you guys want to do is you do want to get the gunner class. This is going to give you an additional 10% armor on kill, which is actually going to go really good with this build. So for the weapon, we have the MOP. Like I said, it's the name shotgun. This one right here, with the build set up at 1.1 million armor, 331,000 health, we have 966,000 total damage, 130 RPM, so you can pretty much spam it a little bit. Has 7-round mag, shotgun damage, damage to armor, and then look at this, 10% armor on kill. So you add that with the gunner class, we already have 20% armor on kill on this build, which is actually really good. So we go down to the talent. I decided to go with close and personal because we want to be within those 7 meters. We want to be up in the face. Killing a target within 7 meters grants 30% weapon damage for 10 seconds. So yeah, this is really going to work here. And the way I modded it, I have the reload speed to allow me to reload quicker, then I have crit chance, and then crit chance. And then that's pretty much what you want with this build. For the secondary, it's really up to you. I have the vector on here. You can run the name, the Dark Winter if you have that. Doesn't really matter. This is just my secondary since this is, I'm gonna have SMG bonuses on here too. So if I need to get an enemy at distance, I always like the Vector SBR 1200 RPM. Same thing with the Dark Winter. If you guys have that. I don't know if I have one on this character, and I don't. So yeah, same thing. If you guys want to, if you have a Dark Winter, same thing, just an Amber. So what we are running is the Hunter's Fury 4-piece. So we're gonna get that 15% shotgun damage, 15% SMG damage. That's why I'm running a primary shotgun, secondary SMG. We get 20% armor on kill. So now we're at 40% armor on kill with this build. And that's a lot of armor kill, especially that means I'm almost getting half of my armor back every time I get a kill. Almost 500,000 armor, we'll check in a second. And we get 100% health on kill. Now enemies within 15 meters receive a debuff amplifying your weapon damage against them by 20%. And that's great. And then every time we kill enemies in a group, it actually benefits us because killing debuff enemy with your weapon disorients other enemies within 5 meters and then amplifies weapon damage by 5% for 10 seconds, stacking up to 5 times. So that's why that can be an additional 25% weapon damage you're getting there amplified. So a lot of damage. We have weapon damage, critical hit damage, and then the critical hit damage mod. For the chest, we're running the Cheska chest. This gives us that 10% critical hit chance. We have weapon damage, critical hit chance, and then a critical hit chance mod. Now, if my backpack had a critical hit chance roll on it, and I'll show you, I would put a critical hit damage mod on here. We have intimidate. While you have bonus armor, it amplifies total weapon damage by 35% to enemies within 10 meters. So going off the weapon talent and this talent, a lot of damage right there, right? But you got to be within that 10 meters and 7 meters. So that's where we want all the action to happen. For the holster, we are running a second piece of Hunter's Fury with weapon damage and critical hit damage. For the knee pads, we have weapon damage, critical hit damage. For the gloves, another weapon, Hunter's Fury. So on this one, to give us some armor, we went with armor and then critical hit chance on here. And then for the backpack, we are running one piece Badge of Tough for that 10% shotgun damage. So we already get an additional, just from the gear set pieces, 15% shotgun damage off the two-piece Hunters and another 10% shotgun damage here. And that's not including all the other amplified damage. We have armor regen, which I would rather have crit chance on here. And that's what I said, I could put another crit damage mod. Increase my crit damage by 12%. We have critical hit damage and then a crit chance mod on here. And then we have adrenaline rush. Whenever you're within 10 meters of an enemy, you gain 20% bonus armor for 5 seconds. Now this does stack up 3 times. And that's pretty good because that can be 60% extra bonus armor of 1.1 million armor. So a nice chunk of armor. You can see how we're just melting these enemies. Now this is a great build to hit those heroic control points, do anything pretty much heroic on the game. This could pretty much handle it. We head over to the stats. You're gonna see 51% crit chance, 115% crit damage, and that's what I was telling you. I can keep that crit chance there and buff this up to 126% crit damage, 65% headshot damage here, 12% armor damage. So a lot of damage, right? But what I want you to see is, like, let's go down a little bit, and then look, armor on kill, almost 500,000 armor on kill. 440,000 armor on kill, which is amazing. So every time we get a kill, we're getting almost half of our armor back every time. And if you start stacking those back to back, it's just, you pretty much keep your armor up. Even if you take a little bit of damage, boom, got another kill, boom, got another kill, and it just works. So yeah, that's the build right here, guys. If you guys have any questions, let me know. I will see you guys in the next one. But until then, hey, nothing but skills is out.